multi-award winning musicians Rhea Hall and Rob Ruha celebrated major wins at the annual Waiata Māori Music Awards last weekend, and they have also pulled their artistic talents for their first dual national tour, Behind the Lines. It's set to be a powerful two-hour show which will be performed across six centres in New Zealand. Rob Ruha joins us now to tell us all about it. Welcome. Chrissy, welcome.
Thank you.
And congratulations.
Thank you.
This is amazing. So let me just get this straight. Between you and Rhea, last weekend you won 5 Waiata Māori Music Awards. You got 4 of those yourself.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Really funny.
How do these awards feel? I mean, how do you feel?
It's a huge honour. It's a huge honour, you know, especially sharing the evening with such amazing talent there. And it was good to also share in the other artists' win as well.
Yeah, you know? I saw some of the coverage I was watching on Instagram, the New Zealand On Air feed, and they were having little snippets of it. It looked like a great evening.
Yeah, it was. It's always a good catch-up, the Waiata Māori Music Awards, yeah.
Yeah. Now, obviously, you know, Rhea, it would make sense that the two of you have had such great wins to join forces for a tour. But why did you decide to go out on tour with Rhea?
Oh, we've been working together on and off for quite some time now. And, you know, we're both related too, so, you know.
Oh, really?
Yep. We've known each other for a little while. We both do kapa haka, and we both also write about similar stuff. Have similar themes that we like to present to people through our music. So I think for both of us it was just a natural thing that we'd come together and pull a show together.
It's been quite a busy time for you guys too, hasn't it? Because you've both released an album this year, haven't you? And your album went straight to number one on iTunes.
Did the number one thing, and it's been, streamed all over the world, and Rhea's is the same. Hers took out the number one spot in, for Best New Zealand Albums for the week that it was released.
That's incredible.
Yeah, so it's done well.
What is it, do you think, about your music that's obviously related, people have related to so much?
I think both of us, we try and, you know, create stuff that's new, that's fresh, but also that resonates with people as well, you know, try and take them along with the journey. You know, it's no use kind of creating this massive vision inside your work and then no one can connect with it. So I think that's what we strive to do as artists, and most artists, I guess, try to do that as well.
Now, I think we've actually got a picture of the tour poster here, and apparently there's a bit of a similarity in the faces.
Yeah, you can tell we're related, huh?
And that's what it says. So you're related. I guess most people wouldn't know that. But
yeah.
You reckon there might be whānau stories come out when you're on tour?
Most definitely, yeah. The thing is, with Kazi Rhea is I was brought up in Hicks Bay where her family are and where our relationship connection is with all her mum's grand aunties, uncles, what have you, and you know, I say to her every day, cousin, you got the Staten strain, and you got the Hokamo strain, and you. She looks like all of her aunties that I was raised with.
Yeah. And the family must be pretty happy that you're doing this too, as well.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's a huge sense of pride that Te Whānau Apanui, people from Te Whānau Apanui, and from our little village in Hicks Bay, Te Whānau Tū Whakaeriora, are rocking it out together.
Is that what you were using? Is that the video that we first looked at? Was that sort of coming in?
Yeah. Special place, that place, a place called Whangaparāwa. In traditional knowledge, it was the place where a lot of the voyaging canoes first landed in Aotearoa, a place called Taungā Waka. And really awesome to go back there, shoot the video with all the family too.
Yes. Oh, that's great. Yeah. Look at that. Beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
It is stunning.
Heaven.
Yeah.
Hey, now, is it true that the tour dates are quite significant? There's something about your tour dates.
We kicked off the very first show at the King's Coronation in August, and the Kingitanga celebrates 160 years of being this year. And we'll end the tour at Ratana Pā, and the Ratana Faith celebrates 100 years this year on the 8th of November. So that's a huge honour. And we hear that every faith denomination in the country will be there to celebrate the 100 years of Ratana. So it's a huge honour for us to situate our tour in between two massive po in the year.
That must be incredible, and you must get little sort of tingles
about
it.
I just like sitting here saying it, tingling.
Look what I'm going to be doing, it's so awesome. And it's been described as a sonic and sensory experience too, the show, so what does that mean?
Yeah, well, we've kind of curated basically as many of the seconds as we can. We've fused our music together. The Witch Doctor, which is the band that features on my album, is creating the sonic bed. They're our band on show. We've got visuals coming in. The guy who usually follows Shapeshifter around, Brother Mark, he's pulling together all the visuals, lighting, everything, full shebang.
Wow.
Yeah.
And the name Behind the Lines kind of suggests that we might learn something about the lines and the songs. Is there a message that you want to get across with this?
Yeah, absolutely. And the biggest message, I guess, is nationhood. I mean, we've just come out of celebrating Te Wiki o Te Reo Māori, and it's those kind of things, those kind of projects, movements that we want to celebrate inside inside the show, definitely, and then in society across the dinner table, normalise those conversations about working together to create a beautiful nation.
You're both two from very strong, as you mentioned before, kapahaka backgrounds. Is there any of that going to be incorporated into the show?
Yeah, all the way through. It kind of permeates in obvious ways and then in discreet ways too. So I guess you have to come along to...
You've
got to come along.
Now, your band, the Witch Doctors, Witch Doctor, is it? Tell us more about them.
Oh yeah, the Witch Doctor, some really, really good friends. They come together from a whole heap of different bands. So Darren Mathiasen is the drummer for Shapeshifter. On the bass is Johnny Lawrence, and he usually plays with Electric Wire Hustle. James on keys, and he plays with a whole heap of people, currently with Bliss and Esso over in Australia. Tina Keelan has played guitar on lots of different Catch a Fire records, and many other people he's worked with, Sammy J, a whole heap of people. So they've all come together and are building the magic that's the music in the show.
Wow, it sounds so exciting. You've got such a passion for it too, and it really comes across. It's making me quite excited. You are also a mentor to many young Māori singers, aren't you, or musicians.
Yep.
How do you find that work?
I think it's important. I think it's important in terms of growing the way we do things as Māori musicians, the messages of this country, and growing the future of the next biggest thing. Katerama Pau, a young girl that we've been mentoring since for about 3 years now. She'll be releasing her first EP at Ratana Pā when we're there. And of course, Soul Sensation Teex is another young fella that we've been mentoring for a little while now too, and he's just blown up doing his own thing now.
Just astounding.
Oh, he's amazing, and the beautiful thing is that there's lots more amazing people like that as well, and we need to get behind them and support them.
With your music, is it just that it's kind of Māori or Māori-inspired music that links the music of you and Rhea together, or does it go beyond that?
I think the music is definitely one part, the messages are another part. You know, we talk about unity, we talk about spirituality, we talk about being, I don't know, the social ills that before all of us, you know. Racism is a real thing for everyone. So we talk about that kind of stuff, confront them. You know, that's the whole thing about Behind the Lines. We've got to take you behind the lines of our thinking.
Yeah.
Go through the hard places, confront them, and then move past that line, create new lines.
Oh, fantastic. Hey, Rob, thank you so much for stopping by.
Choice.
What a pleasure. Rhea Hall and Rob Ruha's Behind the Lines tour kicks off in New Plymouth on Thursday, October the 18th, before taking in 5 other centres around the country. You can check out jackman.co.nz for full details and also your ticket links as well.